Hey everyone, so today I'm doing a video on how to make a beauty binder. For those of you who don't know what a beauty binder is, it's pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It's just like a binder or a folder or notebook, whatever you want. And it's just filled of anything, any beauty products or pictures or anything like that that really inspires your style. And I love mine. I don't know what I would do without mine. It's just really inspirational. And so I just thought I'd do a video on how I put together mine, just some tips for making a really good one, and, you know, just everything you really need to have a beauty binder. So the first thing you want to do is you want to go through all your magazines that you have. I still have so many magazines that I haven't gone through that I'm sure there's tons of stuff that I would really like in them to cut out. But basically, all the magazines I get in, anything that inspires me, I rip it out, I cut it out, and then I save it for when I put in my binder. So then, of course, you also need a binder, and this is mine. It's just plastic, three-ring binder, and then I just made a cute cover for it, and it just has some beauty images on it, like a girl with her hair curled, just a picture of MAC body glitter, and then it just says beauty binder on the top. And then when you open it up, you can see I have all of these pages, and they're just like computer paper, and then I glued it on, and the smell from the glue on mine is so strong, like it's really bad. But anyway, just when you go through, when I first did mine, I kind of separated it into three categories. Or actually four categories. I had makeup, hair, fashion, and then fitness. And then anything that was in between, I had like an in-between pile. And then when I glued them all in, they were all in order. And now that I've had mine for a while, it's kind of gotten a little bit out of order. Like fashion's still towards the back and makeup's in the front and hair's in the middle. But it's all kind of crazy, but I know where it is. I know where everything is. And if I need inspiration for something, I just go through the entire thing anyway. So, first of all, when you open it up, I just have just some, this was actually from Teen Vogue a while ago, this is like the Moroccan theme page, and then I have all of my 17 magazine, like, tutorials, and then usually they'll have a picture, products, and then how to use the products to get the look in the picture. So I just have a few of those, and then I get into, like, more, skipping a few pages, like makeup stuff, just images. Just some covers, and then things that I have, they're, like, in the same category, but I didn't want to waste pages, I just, like, stapled them together. So I have a few pages there, and then this is where the makeup, like, stops, and I'm sort of get into hair and makeup. So I have some pictures of Emma Roberts here, and she's a real big inspiration for my look, like, her hair color, the way she styles it, her makeup. So I have a few pages on her there. And then I have more, like, hair and makeup. And if you have smaller images, I just put them all on one page. And you can see I still have some room here. And I do have, a lot of my pages are blank on the back. But as I go through, I'll, like, before I glue on a new image to a page, I'll look through and I'll be like, oh, there's a blank page. And I could put this image in that spot, so I'll glue it there instead. And just keeps it more organized. And it doesn't necessarily have to be, like, beauty images, too. It could be random stuff. Like, this is just an ad from one of my magazines of The Secret Life of an American Teenager. And I really like Shailene Woodley's hair and makeup here, so I cut that out. And then I have, like, hair tutorials. Just all this stuff. Hair. And then I start to get into the hair and fashion mix. I have more hair images. And these are just, like, just some random things I printed. I don't know why those are in there. And then I get into fashion, and it goes all the way back here, and yeah, I have more blank pages back here because I have less fashion stuff. And then on the end, I have just a folder, and I have, these are like, these are all from American Eagle actually, but they're like bigger, they're like they send them in the mail, and they're almost like a magazine, but not really. And they'll show, like, some of their new stuff that they got in. It'll always have some deals. Like, this one is from this year's summer/spring collection, and this one's from 2 years ago. But it's not only the clothes, too, the hair and makeup of the models I really like, too. And then on the other side, I have all my fitness stuff. And most of them are from 17 Magazine. Like, they have the rip-out, like, fitness pages. So I have all of those. Some are from, like, Self Magazine or Women's Health. So all of those. And then behind that, I just have, just blank pages that I'll use. And sometimes I'll do, like, a shopping list of, like, any hair products or makeup products I want to buy, and I'll write that down. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I really love my beauty binder. I just think it's very inspirational. Just being able to flip through it whenever I'm out of ideas on how to do stuff is really great, and I love it. So I hope this tutorial slash like how-to video helps you guys put together your own beauty binder. Comment below if you make your own. I want to hear about it. So yeah. Bye.